Hey guys, it's Steven and Ellie the Chihuahua here. This is going to be a little bit more of a practical video because I'm going to be cutting Ellie's nails because they are far too long at the moment. The best way to know if your dog's nails are too long is when they're walking, particularly across a wooden floor. If you can hear like the pitter-patter of their nails on the floor, generally that's a sign they're getting slightly too long. Either way, Ellie's nails need a cut, so let's get started. As you can see, Ellie's nails are really quite long at the moment. They desperately need a cut. This is actually a really good shot because in every dog's nail there is a vein. You can kind of see that here, that Ellie has a white nail and then it starts to go a little bit more pink. That is where the vein starts. So you want to make sure you avoid cutting the nails in this area. I have some doggy nail scissors here. Start very, very slow with your dog. And don't take too much away because you don't want to hit that nerve. I've just put the scissors around Ellie's nail and I'm just going to clip that away gently. And we've got a clean cut there. All whilst you're doing this, you want to give your dog some treats so they see it as a positive thing. Good girl, Ellie. Good girl. You like that, don't you? You like that? And we're just going to move on to the next nail. Good girl, good girl. I've actually been doing this with Ellie since she was a little girl, so she's very used to the routine. Good girl. You want to make sure you stay very calm whilst you're doing this. You don't want to go in there too deep because you could hit the vein. If you do hit the vein and the toenail starts to bleed, you just have to be prepared for the fact that it is going to bleed for quite a long time. I would say up to an hour, if not over an hour, depending on how much of the vein you cut into. If there is a lot of blood and you're getting really concerned, I would call your vet and just ask them for some advice as to what you should do, whether you should bring them in. They told me that a little bit of baking soda or cornstarch with flour is a great thing to put onto a dog's bleeding nail because it helps to stop the bleeding and then seal up the injury. The nail will stay quite tender for a week or so until the nail grows back. But as you can see here, Ellie's nails are now blunt and nowhere near as long as they were at the start of this video. If you're worried about doing this yourself, which is fine, you can always ask your vet to do it or go to a local dog grooming salon. But it is really easy to do at home, especially if you've got a small dog. Maybe give it a go and see how you get on. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification button, and we will see you again next week. Won't we, Ellie? Say bye.